It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
What's happening, everybody? Tonight, we'll get to see the Miami Heat go up against the Indiana Pacers at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Taking a look at the Pacers, a tough loss for them in Game 3. That one really could have gone either way. They are confident that with a few tweaks, they'll fare better tonight. To call this a one-sided series might be an understatement. Jack, is there any hope of making this a contest?
I don't see any drastic changes that could be made to spark a comeback in this series. At this point, I think we're just playing for pride.
It ain't over till it's over, Ernie. Everyone expects you to get eliminated now, so the pressure's off. Just play your game.
Hold it. You said, it ain't over till it's over. Let me write that down, because that's good.
No one's ever said that in the history of basketball.
It ain't over till it's what?
Over.
Oh. Over. That's
over.
That's Monday.
OVA.
Oh, I was O-V-U-H. Whatever. Here's Kevin Harlan.
The buildings of Indianapolis are location tonight framed against the beautiful nighttime sky. It's Game 4 of this Eastern Conference quarterfinal series. Down 3-0. It's a survival contest, no doubt. Will the series end here tonight? Thanks for tuning in to the NBA playoffs on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here, along with Steve Smith, Greg Anthony, David Aldridge on our sideline. It's our pleasure to welcome in the sports guy, Bill Simmons, to our broadcast for a second straight year. It's an honor to have you here courtside with us.
I'm just excited that I got brought back. I felt like I was on Brook Lopez on the one-year contract last year, and then now you've invited me back.
But you've
it's another one-year
you've
contract.
You've reinvented yourself, though.
Yeah,
you can hit outside comments.
I tried to expand my range, you know, but so we'll see. We'll take it year by year.
We can't wait to hear it. D.A., take it away.
Well, Victor Oladipo has a huge task and a long road in front of him making his way back from that knee injury. But you talk to his teammates, and they rave about his mental makeup. They say he's an incredible person, great to be around, the most positive guy they've ever played with. So, Kevin, if anyone can come back from this, he can.
You better believe it. Outstanding, David. Thank you. Terrific two-way player Jimmy Butler, best all-around shooting guard in the NBA.
I don't think so. I think Bradley Beal and Klay Thompson are probably give you a little more on that end. And they're also younger. Mm-hmm. And with Jimmy, like, you just, if you're the best all-around shooting guard in the game, like, you have to get past round two, in my opinion. So I for me, it's Klay Thompson because he's been such a crucial part of all of these important Warriors teams, you know. So I you got to take the title from him by winning some playoff series.
So the opening lineup for the Heat, Jay Crowder out there with Bam Adebayo. And there's Iguodala. And there's Jimmy Butler. And it's Dragic in at the point. And for the Pacers, Sabonis and Turner up front. Oladipo is the two with Warren playing small forward. And it's Brogdon in at the one. Clock at four. And Sabonis the bucket on the assist from Brogdon.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
No excuse. You have to be aware. He should be on your radar all the time.
Butler, no good. So Oladipo will bring it up for the Indiana Pacers. Passes it to Warren. Back to Oladipo. And it's Miami with the rebound. Pass to Dragic. It's over Brogdon. Second chance shot. And Adebayo with the lay-in.
And an efficient start here offensively, working it inside for the easy two.
Brogdon the pass to Sabonis. There's the lob to Oladipo. Butler in the corner. He goes up again. Nice D from Sabonis.
They are out of rhythm. 1 for 5 so far.
You just need to calm down and reward your matchups.
Warren kicks to Brogdon. Outside Warren. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Shooting two.
That free throw good from Warren. You've been producing documentaries, going deeper into athlete stories, which I know you love, because I think you're curious more than anything else.
Yep.
So what drew you to that process?
Initially, it was we dove into these stories. We thought that was the inefficiency of, instead of these big, broad type of documentaries, concentrate on events and players and moments and things like that. And I think as you get into that and you start doing it, it just becomes intoxicating. And the cool thing about it is no story should be told the same way you would tell somebody else's story. You just don't know. You've got to figure it out. Like, we had Steve Nash, his last Lakers season. He wanted to do a documentary about it. And then we spitballed it, and we decided it was actually a better idea to do an in-the-moment digital series about it that you could experience in real time with the thing. And it was the right idea, and that was really good. I think trying to figure out what story clicks the best with an athlete, how to tell whatever story they have correctly, is the coolest part about that.
Shooting two.
And he knocks down the first one. Oladipo hits them both. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Here's Butler. Miami no good on that time either. Indiana leading by three. Warren, the pass to Brogdon. And the pass to Oladipo. Six on the shot clock. And it's Miami with the rebound. They come into this game following a tremendous win on Wednesday.
And really showed their depth when they needed it most. On the road, having to manufacture points.
It was really that second wave in the rotation that took the offense to another level.
Now, here's Brogdon. Victor Oladipo unable to get his last shot to go. Pulls it up. And a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in. And the Oladipo injury last year, many teams would have folded in losing an all-star like that, but head coach Nate McMillan refused to wave the white flag, got his team together, they played a little bit differently,
yeah.
And they survived.
They did, and I think the biggest reason they survived is they're in the Eastern Conference. And it's a lot easier to survive when you're in the same conference where Orlando goes like 22-11 to end the season.
Yes.
I was impressed by the fight they had, and you really saw in the playoffs like how little talent they had. You know, they were kind of hanging around those first couple Celtic games. And then you have, like, Wesley Matthews taking the game-deciding shot. And, you know, they really were scrappy, and they definitely overachieved. To lose your best player when you have no other All-Star on the team and still make the playoffs and do what they did, I thought was impressive.
Shows you how impressive it can be to have a player like Oladipo who plays both ends very well.
Right.
But the importance of an All-Star on that team is...
Yes.
You can't make the postseason without it.
And actually weirdly good for him to get a taste of not being there. And sometimes guys come back from that and they're at even a higher level.
The Heat making a switch here. Nunn's checked in. Sabonis with the bucket. Here's Nunn.
Sabonis.
Outside Butler. Pass to Nunn. Nothing is falling for him right now. passes it to Brogdon. Nice pass, nice catch, and a resounding dunk.
Yeah, we're seeing some fireworks from them already.
They established the pace. They made shots. This is why they're way out in front.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
And just trying to get some traction offensively. Boy, it hasn't been pretty.
You know, this is a good time to maybe switch up your strategy a little bit. You can't keep doing what you're doing and expect a different result.
Here's Nunn. Butler on the wing, trying to end the drought, and the layup is up and in. Miles Turner, the lengthy big man for Indiana, challenges shots, we know that, protects the rim well. The jump shot of his is not too big.
Yeah, and sometimes he has these little moon shots in traffic that I really like. He is the X factor for this Pacers team. They need him to become not an all-star, but a borderline all-star. Somebody that can eventually be like a 19-9 type guy. Oladipo needs a sidekick. Turner, the pieces are there. I haven't seen him been able to put it together yet. He's also like 14 years old,
yeah,
so there's plenty of time.
Oh, here's Crowder. Victor Oladipo unable to get his last shot to go. They get it again. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
That's just staying in the moment, keeping with the current possession.
Miami shooting their first free throw of the night here. Kelly Olynyk checked in for Miami. Free throw good. Adebayo. Pacers leading by five. Now Brogdon. Oladipo outside. And a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in. Oladipo's got 7 points in the game.
To stretch out the defense, you just need enough guys on the floor who can make that shot.
Here's Butler. And it's sent back by Turner. They retain possession. Olynyk finds Butler. Nice D for Warren.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
The rim protection at its finest. The result is the same whether you block the shot or simply change it. The will is there, but the execution is lacking. He can't seem to finish plays this quarter.
Butler with the ball. Sabonis defending. The shot misses. So the Pacers will take it the other way.
And another miss. Oof. He's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right.
And what a way to start this game, dominating at both ends of the floor.
They came in prepared, focused, and really jumped on the other team early.
Here's Nunn. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. It's blocked. Now the Pacers moving it up. Brogdon leading the charge. The coast-to-coast dunk.
Love the recognition. Realizes that one is all him.
Sometimes that's the call. You want to be unselfish, but even more so, you want to be effective.
Bill, you host your own podcast. I've listened to it. I subscribe to it.
Thank you.
I love it. What do you make of so many NBA players now doing the same thing?
And we have a couple of them. At the Ringer, we have J.J. Redick, and we have Vince Carter and Kent Bazemore. The ones that are good at it take it seriously. It can't be one of those things where, you know, a player says, you know what, I want a podcast, and then it just magically happens, and you got to work on it. you have to use your connections and book your guests, and you have to be candid on the podcast. You can't just show up and just babble. And the guys that have been successful at it are people that could probably have a media career for a living. Like JJ is clearly going to go in the media after he retires. Richard Jefferson had a great podcast. He's gone in the media. He's really good. So I think you need a little more talent at it than people realize. And you need the consistency of it. You can't say, I'm starting a podcast, and then not do it for 2 months. Like, you have to really stick to it.
Pacers have gone 3 of 4 at the free throw line tonight.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
The first free throw is good. Drops them both.
Money from the stripe. He does a great job night in and night out.
Here's Nunn. He's covered by McConnell. Floats one. Nunn can't get it to fall. Pacers leading by 12. McDermott kicks to McConnell. Back to McDermott. Pass to McConnell. Just 5 on the clock. That one off the back iron and out. The Heat trail by 12. And there's the pass to Nunn. Here's Hero. Here's Adebayo. He's covered by McConnell. High arcing shot. And Adebayo with a nice bucket inside. Adebayo's got 7. And it's McConnell with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Indiana Pacers. And, Bill, when it comes to NBA awards, some people have said voter fatigue is a factor. Would you agree with that?
No, I actually think NBA awards are in the best shape they've been in because people are afraid to screw up. You know, that with the Internet and the accountability we have now.
Accountability, exactly. And there's also nothing anonymous about it.
No. Yeah. And we have really good numbers and metrics now, and I actually think we make the right decisions with this stuff most of the time now. I didn't really see any egregious stuff last year other than the one person who voted Dwayne Wade for second team All NBA.
You get a vote, don't you?
I do, and I take it really seriously.
I do too.
Yeah.
I feel the same way.
And I really care.
Our name is attached to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I also, like, when I wrote my book, I really relied on the All NBA stuff. Like, they're a snapshot of what happened that season.
Good point. And so here is Indiana. After the Heat pick up 2. Here's Sabonis. Buries it down low. He's got 7.
Allowing any room to operate, you know he's going to be aggressive.
Kicks it to Jones. Here's Hero. Covered by Lamb. Astro Linick. Outside. Jones. Heat moving the ball around. Astro Linick. Pulls up. Trying to get open is Adebayo. And it's Miami with another. Pacers leading by 6. Outside, Lamb. Over to the wing. Olynyk with the steal. And here again, the Heat in transition. Up the court they go. Nunn, that's good.
Yeah, they are really starting to push it now.
Indiana's gone 3 of 4 on three-pointers in the first quarter, doing well from long range. To the middle, here's Lamb. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points, so 1 free throw coming up.
Attacking the rack to great effect.
The Pacers have shot a good percentage from the free throw line so far. They've made 5 out of 6. Jay Crowder's checked in for Adebayo.
Man, they are just living at the line.
50 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Here's Nunn. That's good for his third bucket. Now 3 for 6 from the field.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
Now, here's McConnell. He's been patient so far, nothing on the scoreboard yet. Olynyk against Turner, down to 5 on the shot clock. 14 feet away, and Lamb with the basket on the assist by McDermott. And that's now 7 points for Jeremy Lamb. Nunn passes to Olynyk. Here's Nunn over McConnell. Out of bounds, Indiana takes possession.
This is what we talk about, valuing each possession, avoiding those kinds of mistakes.
With 1 on the clock, no good, shot missing. And so it's the Indiana Pacers heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Tough nose Jimmy Butler talks about the mantle of being a franchise player.
You call me a leader, all-star, whatever you want to call it, but with that comes a lot of, you know, some people call it pressure, but a lot of responsibility is what I call it. You know, every night you got to show up. You have to be productive. You have to show guys even when you're hurt, you can still play. Even when you're tired, you got to go out there and do what you're supposed to do. It's fun to me. I love it. I wouldn't have it any other way.
And that's what he worked for. And he works as hard as anyone, Greg, in the NBA.
And you see that competitiveness and desire in his play.
And we welcome you back to Game 4 on 2K Sports. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Pacers?
I love their effort, contesting shots, trying to intimidate here early on.
And you can see it's already having an impact. It can cause shooters to think twice.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the court for the Heat, they've got Dragic. Kelly Olynyk is out there with Jay Crowder. Then it's Jones. And it's Hero into the 2. Now here's Dragic. Following the missed shot by Sabonis.
When you try to defend this guy, Goran Dragic, you got to remember, he's a high-energy player. Those dudes, they tend to draw fouls.
The Heat have made their only other free-throw attempt today in an earlier trip to the line. And that one misses.
A rare bad trade by the San Antonio Spurs. Dragic was their second-round pick in 2008. They traded his rights to the Suns for a player who didn't even make the roster.
He hits the second from the line. Bill, it was in Boston where you received your master's degree in journalism. What attracted you to this profession? Why journalism?
I couldn't do anything else, and I didn't like manual labor.
Oh, really?
No, that really was it. I was good at writing.
Like anybody in your family or anybody you
are? No, I was a good writer, and I liked writing and sports. Yeah. So I'm just kind of like, oh, I'll do those two things
together. Did it in high school, I'm assuming?
Yeah, started in high school. I had the big thing for me was in college, I had a column for the school newspaper, really from freshman year on. And around sophomore year of college, I started to get momentum. And that was the first time I thought, when did I get paid for this? Which, as it turned out, no, until I was about 29.
Yeah.
Beautiful vision to find the open man. Gorn leading by example.
McConnell kicks to Lamb. Olynyk with the steal. Here's Hero. That doesn't go on the chance to tie.
Great defensive effort. Just saved a basket.
You know what? This is why you never give up on a play. You don't know what's going to happen.
Now, here's McConnell. He's been quiet so far, still no points in the game. And it's Dragic with the foul. And that'll be his third foul so far. The Pacers making a switch here. Warren's checked in. So it's the Pacers now. Nothing offensively yet from them in the second quarter. And he's fouled on the shot. It misses, so a couple of free throws here. Almost the chance for a three-point play.
Really, the right play defensively, if you can't block, force him to the line.
For Indiana, they had put up good numbers at the charity stripe, converting 6 of 7.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw good. Sabonis. The Heat making a switch here. Butler's checked in. Sabonis drops them both. The Heat trail by 4. Bill, if you were just hired as a GM, which franchise would you model your approach after?
I really like what the Clippers did the last couple years when they realized they didn't have quite enough to win the title. And instead of just being beholden to being darn close but not quite, they actually like blew it up and tried to figure out how to create cap space, find some young players,
and still stay competitive.
Build
so they kept the momentum of their franchise.
Yeah, they stumbled into a situation where they had a lot of flexibility no matter what. I think the Celtics before them did the same thing in the mid 2000s. They're just trying to find assets and figure it out and fly. That's the approach I would use. I would never fully commit one way or the other to anything. The goal is to try to accumulate assets and figure out what you have. And I think the smartest teams do that.
Now here's McDermott. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Poked away. And Dragic with a clear path to the hoop. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Such a fiery, competitive dude. Goran Dragic is making things happen. Now he's going to the line.
The Heat have gone 2 for 3 at the foul line in this game. And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. Victor Oladipo, he's checked in for the Pacers. Malcolm Brogdon comes in for T.J. McConnell. Heat also with a sub. Andre Iguodala, he's checked in for Hero. And Goran Dragic drops them both.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Here's Oladipo. That's tipped, and they'll keep possession. Sabonis, no good.
Woo, blown opportunity right there. Won't get many chances easier than that one.
Dragic looking for an opening, and the foul on Victor Oladipo. That's his first foul. Indiana on D, trailing by 2. 6 to shoot. And it's Butler missing. And it's Warren with the ball for the Indiana Pacers. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. It's going to be on Jay Crowder. Pacers have shot the ball well from the free throw line, 8 of 9.
shooting two.
That free throw, no good. And the second free throw, good. Heat on offense. They're on an 11-3 run right now. Iguodala with it. Now defended by Oladipo. That'll go on McDermott. That is his first foul of the game.
And still early in the period, and they're only one foul away from being over the limit.
Outside, Dragic. Shot clock at 6. The shot, no good. Nice D from Sabonis. Indiana trailing here. Here's Warren. Offensive rebound. And the rejection by Iguodala.
And Iggy demonstrating his trademark defense yet again. Just a sensational shot block.
Butler, no good.
He really can't buy a bucket. But his teammates have his back.
Brogdon with it. Oladipo outside. And he uses the glass on the layup. Oladipo's got 12 in the game.
That's a well-timed, well-coordinated play. Comes right off the pick for the lay-in.
Crowder, the pass to Iguodala. Outside, Butler. Gets it to fall, but still just 2 for 10 from the floor this game.
Those 220 pounds came in handy. Jimmy Butler using his big body and muscling those tough shots.
Rocked in the pass to Oladipo. Got a piece of it. They recover it. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. Here's Crowder, and it's Miami with another.
Shut out in the first quarter. He's heating up now. I like the aggressiveness.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Brogdon finds Sabonis. Rebound by Olynyk.
And for his offense, this has just been a brutal period.
That one drops for him. Now it's a 5-point Heat lead.
That's a fantastic dribble move from Butler. He's extremely confident with his dribble.
Brogdon outside. Oladipo outside. Back to Brogdon. From deep 3-point range, and they force the shot clock violation. Great D. The Heat making a switch here. Here's Nunn. 6 points for him. Heat moving the ball around. Butler passes to Nunn. Shoots over Brogdon. That one wide left. Pacers trail by 5. Knocked away. Back to Warren. Lock at 6. To end the drought. Pass to Brogdon. And here's McDermott. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Warren, that's for 2. Now here's McDermott, defended by Butler. McDermott passes to Warren. Tries yet again. Finally gets one to fall. He's now 1 for 5 with his first make. Here's Miami now. They're on a 17-7 run. Iguodala dishes to Butler. trying to get up and is out of iron. Shots good from Butler. Butler's got the lead up to five now for the Heat.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
And the Pacers call time here.
The wheels have come off a little bit leading up to this timeout. He has taken some low percentage shots, and it's killing the floor of their offense. More motion, more ball movement, that should lead to better looks for him and for the entire team.
Turner's checked in for the Pacers. Heat also with a sub. Jones has checked in. Warren finds Turner. Now Brogdon. Six on the shot clock. The shot by Turner, no good.
And his pure defensive effort changed that shot from an easy one to a tough one.
And you know, technically, it's a high percentage look, but this is why we play the game.
And the ceiling Turner has is impressive. Has the potential to be a dominant big man in this league.
For Indiana, they have shot 9 of 11 at the free throw line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw missing. Jeremy Lamb's checked in for McDermott. And he's good on the second. The Heat leading by 4. Now here's Iguodala. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Here's Nunn. He's guarded by Brogdon. The kick out to Crowder. Lets it go from deep. Score the basket. His 4th. He's only missed 1 of his 5 shots tonight.
This is what Crowder loves to do. He's out there saying, set me up, please.
Brogdon finds Lamb. Now the pass to Warren. Shot clock at 5. Over Jones. That's in, and the Miami lead is cut to just 5 on the basket from Warren.
And despite the hot start from beyond, they've gotten away from shooting the triple.
Nunn passes to Crowder. He doesn't hit that one. Nice D from Warren.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Lamb against Iguodala. Well, Bill, I know you've got to run. Marvelous to have you on the program. Wish we could do it more often.
Let's do it right now. I don't have to run. Can I stay?
Yes, you can always stay.
I don't want to leave.
You have a free ticket here anytime you want.
I want to stay, please.
The microphone's always open.
Thank you.
And, Steve, you get the sense that no NBA topic is off limits when you talk to Bill Simmons.
He gets the discussion going, whether you agree or disagree with him. That's part of what makes sports fun, having those debates. And sometimes we get to see the players in the debate on the court.
For Indiana, they have shot 10 of 13 from the free throw line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. The Pacers making a change here. McConnell's checked in. Hero's checked in for Miami. All free throws good from Turner. The Heat leading by 3. Here's Hero. There's 47 seconds left in the first half of basketball. And here's the break. Goes back up. A shot by McConnell, no good. And so here is Miami, Crowder. And again, it's the Heat missing.
He looked just a little out of rhythm. He's still trying to establish consistency from there.
McConnell finds Oladipo. That misses, had a chance to tie it there.
He's had a tough time getting it going, and he's put this team behind the eight ball.
Hero, no good. McConnell passes to Oladipo, and finished off by Oladipo.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. And that'll do it for the first half, a competitive game so far. Miami ahead, up by one. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
Much different. I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back. This is Ernie Johnson with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. How about the playoff atmosphere? We're going to break down all the first half action for you. For the Heat, maybe they haven't been as superior in this game as they've been in the previous three, but they're still in position to advance with a 4-0 sweep and get a few extra days off before the next round. Kenny, let's start with you. What'd you think about the Heat?
Well, their reserves showed up tonight, not just on hustle plays, but in points. And that's what you got to do coming off the bench to maximize your minutes.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Indiana?
I like the way they rebounded. They devoted a lot of energy down low, fighting for each other on the boards. And it helped keep this game tight. If they can continue to do that, it could easily be the factor that swings the game in their favor.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
And we're with you again as our round one coverage continues. Victor Oladipo really making a difference here.
Well, we'll find out if they were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease in that first half.
I think both sides probably adjusted a few things. The key for him is to bring the same level of energy over these last two quarters.
Well, it doesn't get much better than playoff basketball. Let's get back to the action here in round one. Oladipo is the two with Warren playing small forward. Sabonis and Turner up front, and it's Brogdon in at the point guard position. So that's the group out there for Indiana. Now here's Crowder. The bucket is good. He'll have a chance for one more. It's going to go on Sabonis.
I mean, a beautiful combination of power and concentration. Crowder as relentless as they come.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
Contributions from Jay Crowder, extremely valuable because of his defense, toughness, and switchability.
Again against Dragic. Now, here's Warren. He's tightly guarded. Turner trying to free himself up. Some solid defense from Butler.
What a defensive play. Gets the stop and does it without fouling.
And Adebayo throws it down.
Iggy just keeping his head up on his swivel all the time.
Brogdon the pass to Sabonis. Oladipo against Iguodala. Sabonis kicks to Oladipo. Shot clock at 6. Miami grabs the miss.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
The rim protection at its finest. The result is the same whether you block the shot or simply change it.
Shots good from Butler.
3 straight to begin this half. Couldn't have drawn it up any better.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Back to Sabonis. He kicks it to Oladipo. And the Pacers can't get it to go.
They've come out ice cold to start this half. 3 misses and as many attempts. And coming out of halftime, coach said they wanted to start fast. Howell's 4 for 4.
Timeout called, the Pacers.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
And it boils down to the question, toughness. One team showing it, the other allowing itself to be bullied.
Minutes gone in this third quarter now. Pass to Brogdon. Passes it to Oladipo. Just 5 on the clock. Over Iguodala. And once again off the mark by Indiana.
All the energy is on the other side right now, and every miss just makes it worse.
You know what? This has always been a debate. Do you take the timeout or do you let your guys try to fight through it?
First one falls for. Kelly Olynyk's checked in for the Heat. Brogdon hits them both. A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Olynyk the pass to Iguodala. Outside, Butler fires for 3. Victor Oladipo grabs the miss. Oladipo's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
But only the first miss of the second half. They've come out here with authority.
Now, here's Brogdon. 6 points for him. 6 to shoot. Back to Sabonis. Oladipo for 3, and they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. The Heat leading by 9. Outside, Dragic. He dishes it to Iguodala. Butler feeling out of it. Here's Adebayo. Good work defensively by Turner. And Brogdon's got the ball here for the Pacers. We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. And he's good on the 3 ball. Brogdon's got 9. Miami's gone 3-6 tonight when they played 5 from downtown. And he's going up for the alley-oop. The shot by Adebayo, no good.
And what should have been a simple pass and finish ends up in a missed opportunity on that alley-oop attempt.
It started off looking good, but the timing was just a little off, and sometimes that's all it takes. This is what the analytics prefer, shots at the rim or from 3.
Brogdon kicks to Turner. Iguodala against Oladipo. Back to Turner. There's the triple. It's hauled in by the Heat. Olynyk's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Dragic with it. 5 points in the game. Position out to Olynyk. Rocket 6. Here's Iguodala. And Oladipo pulls it down. Oladipo's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Up top, Brogdon. Sabonis against Olynyk. And here's Sabonis. He's got 9. Oladipo misses.
Hard to catch up when you can't hit shots. This is a quarter he liked to forget.
Adebayo, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. And he's now got the double-double. 11 points and 12 rebounds.
And folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. Call time to just let them get their legs back under them.
And some changes here for the Pacers. McDermott's checked in for Miles Turner. Jeremy Lamb comes in for Warren. And it's T.J. McConnell in for Oladipo. And Miami with a change here, too. Heroes checked in. Now, here's McConnell. No points in the game yet for him. Sinks that one from the post.
Beautiful call that time up the floor. The hard screen frees him up for the bunny.
Hero passes to Olynyk. Lamb against Buck. Pass to Dragic. Over McConnell. Nice spin off the left rim and in. And that's now 7 points for Goran Dragic.
Well, we know Goran Dragic is very crafty. He can get his shot off in that mid-range area.
The pass to Sabonis. Brogdon outside. Puts it up from 15. And no good. Now the Heat take it the other way. Here's Hero. Down low. Here's Adebayo. That's the 6th make from the field. He's taken 9 shots and missed but 3.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Outside to Brogdon. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Yeah, just nice strength there, and then just off with the shot.
On the night, he's gone 2 for 2 at the stripe. That free throw, no good. No luck that time either.
Very surprising he couldn't capitalize on those shots. You don't see that often.
Jones drives in. That one goes in.
That's their 3rd straight make off an assist.
Pacers trail by 14. Now McConnell. Rebound by Olynyk.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game. And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
Here's McConnell after the Heat pick up 2. To halt the run. Good on the jump shot.
And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
Here's Hero. No good that time. Good D by Brogdon. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Pass to Sabonis. Now McConnell. Brogdon outside. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. The Heat leading by 14. Inside. Adebayo with the bucket. Adebayo's got 10 points in the quarter.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Now, here's McConnell. He's guarded closely. Sabonis finds Brogdon. Got a hand on it. Here's Nunn. He's covered by McConnell. Count that bucket.
Man, just adding insult to injury. He just waltzes inside and extends this lead.
A uncontested shot at the rim. You have to compete at all times.
Now, here's Brogdon. 9 points in the game so far. To the inside. McDermott passes to Sabonis. Indiana needs to get a shot off. Here's McConnell. They grab their own miss.
Challenging the defense at the rim, something he does very well. Excellent tipping.
Now the Heat with it. They're on a 16-6 run. Here's Hero. Dishes it to Olynyk. Here's Nunn. He's covered by McConnell. Passes to Hero. And the Heat get another bucket right there.
And ever since halftime, they played precision basketball offensively.
You know, the coach has had something to say about that. No question, they've settled in and executed brilliantly.
And that one's good, Brogdon.
Talk about making halftime adjustments. You love what they're doing with him now offensively.
Here's Nunn. He's covered by McConnell. And Brogdon comes over to help. Nunn passes to Olynyk. It's good from long range. Olynyk's got six.
Yeah, listen, if you're 7 foot and can shoot threes, there's a place for you in today's NBA. Olynyk has that rare combination.
Now, here's Brogdon. He's got 11. Knocked loose. And it's the Heat on the break. Shot's good by Hero. Hero's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And with their hot shooting here in the second half, their field goal percentage over 50% now for the game.
Pass to Sabonis. Brogdon outside. Back to Sabonis. Goes up again. They get a bet. And finally they hit one. He's got 13.
And the D getting outworked there on the putback. Can't let that happen.
For some reason, blocking out has become a lost art, and that's the result you'll get.
Here's Hero. 8 points for him. To the paint, none. That's all good, and that's his fifth basket of the game. He's shooting 5 for 11 now.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass. And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
Here's Hero. Misses there. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Heat lead by 19. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Indianapolis. And let's listen in on what Nate McMillan had to say to his team.
All right, offensively, okay, let's make sure we get into something. All right, we're just playing again. We don't have our spacing. All right, know who we have out there. All right, and take advantage of it. Come on.
You can tell by his voice there, GA, the offense looking uncharacteristic to him.
The spacing and ball movement is important, and right now, The coach just wants them to be sharp.
And we're happy to have you back for more playoff basketball here in round one. On the floor for Miami, starting the fourth, they've got Adebayo, Jay Crowder out there with Jones, and there's Iguodala. And it's Nunn in at the point. Here's McConnell. Miami grabs the miss.
Great focus on the defensive end there to contest that shot.
And this is where you would prefer to work the ball to someone else for just a better look.
Victor Oladipo grabs the miss. Oladipo's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Lays it up and banks it in. Oladipo's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for the Pacers. Iguodala against Oladipo. And that's a foul called on T.J. Warren. That's foul number 2 for him. Butler, he's checked in for Bam Adebayo. We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. And Jones slams it home.
Jimmy Butler is on it. Staying alert. Finds his man breaking free.
The pass to Oladipo. Shot clock at 6. He can't get it to go. Good D by Jones. The Heat leading by 19. Here's Nunn. Good work there as it goes.
A tale of two halves. He's really turned it around here, scoring the ball.
Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Warren on the wing. Defended by Jones. Looking to get it going. Good D by Jones.
Great defensive effort. Just saved a basket.
You know what? This is why you never give up on a play. You don't know what's going to happen.
And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2. And the foul goes against Miami. First free throw is good. The Heat making a switch here. Krogic has checked in. He hits one and misses one each at the line. The Heat leading by 20. In the corner, Iguodala with it. And the 3 off target.
So frustrating when you can't get anything to go down as you're trying to help your team finish the job.
Whoops. Got caught in between moves there on his way to the rack.
Out to the right wing. Here's Dragic from outside. And there's the foul on Jay Crowder. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. The Pacers have gone just 1-6 from the field to start the fourth quarter. A bit of a slowdown for them right now. We're in the final quarter of play here, 3 minutes in, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Andre Iguodala. That's his first foul. McConnell kicks to Lamb. Down to 5 on the shot clock.
I mean, he closed the gap on that play with his speed. Jimmy Butler on defense is a treat to watch.
And Jones with the stuff.
Playing with high energy, outworking the defense up the floor.
And I just love it when the fast break results in a high percentage look. Not always the case these days.
Now, here's Oladipo. Back to Turner. Kicks it to Oladipo. Launches it. Jay Crowder pulls it in.
Not in rhythm. He had the two triples in the first half. None so far in the second.
Pass to Dragic. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Boy, he's a player who battles for everything he gets. Dragic with the chance to tack on one more.
Sabonis, he's checked in for Indiana. And so it's McConnell with it. He'll bring it up for Indiana. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
And it's Dragic with the foul. That will be foul number 5 on him. So Indiana ends up with a new group on the floor. And Holiday kicks to Holiday. 6 on the shot clock. Back to Holiday. Over Robinson. And a little luck that time, but it drops. Now here's Dragic. Outside Robinson. Hill passes to Leonard. Outside Dragic. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. And that's 13 points for Goran Dragic.
And certainly, they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
The 11-footer, the shot by Holiday, no good.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one. And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. Now here is Holiday. Passes it to Holiday. From 12 feet out, it's not going to go for him. Miami's gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. Robinson, that's good.
And this is why coaches talk about playing with pace. The scoreboard tells it all.
It's a winning approach when you execute. That's the key. They're playing fast, but also under control.
And here are the Pacers now, following the score by Miami. Holiday, the teardrop falls in. Holiday's got 4 points this quarter.
Justin Holiday with the aggressive move, getting better and better off the bounce.
Ball's knocked loose, and here we go. Holiday heading to the hoop, and Holiday throws it down.
He takes advantage of them in every way possible.
And Greg, he lures them into a trap on the steal, and then bang, straight to the bucket.
Great activity at both ends. Great teamwork as well.
Now here's Dragic. Holiday with the block. Here's Sampson, up and in on the layup.
I love it. Beautiful job getting to the rim, making a play.
Holiday against Dragic. He kicks to Leonard. Hill has the open look, sinks the triple.
He is cold-blooded, drops the dagger. Piles on to what was already a big lead.
I mean, defensively, if you have any hope of coming back in this game, you can't afford to give him those looks.
So it's the Pacers now. The Heat knocking down the tray. Holiday finds Holiday. The tray. Rebound by the Heat.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Silva, the pass to Hill. Out of bounds, Indiana takes possession. Indiana's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Pass to Oladipo. The floater, and it's good on the way in. Oladipo's got 4 points this quarter.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Outside, Dragic. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's going to go on Sabonis.
Showing the courage and strength to take it up inside. Gorn will now go to the line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. So both teams making some changes here. And Goran Dragic drops them both.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Holiday against Robinson. The pass to Leaf. Back to Holiday. Plenty of space. And that one drops for him. Holiday's got 8 points here in this quarter.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
From 13, and that one goes long.
Empty possession, and you don't want to miss these easy looks.
Dragic against Holiday. Shoots over Dragic. The shot by Holiday, no good. Here's Hill, and Hill throws it down.
Sky high, one of his advantages as an undersized four.
Indiana's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's Bitadze. No good there. The Heat go the other way with it. Dragic with it. Puts it up from 15. Here's Silva. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
Really nice job to convert the putback opportunity there. I mean, he stayed with that play from start to finish. That's something we say about him a lot.
Now here is Holiday. Pass to Bitadze. Great D that time from Leonard. Miami's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Dragic against Holiday. Hill passes to Dragic. On the wing, and the Heat get another bucket right there.
I mean, tremendous quickness off the pick and roll. Goran Dragic will run this on you all day.
Dragic against Holiday. From the line, and Holiday with the basket on the assist by Holiday. Holiday's got 10 points in just the second half. Miami's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the three-point shot tonight. Very respectable.
And guys, just really impressed. They made big plays when it counted, and that's why it's going to be on to the next round for the Heat.
Tonight, they did a great job of getting everyone involved. They had the good passing, and that led to some open shots.
Solid play, definitely, Kevin.
Taking no chances, they go on one last run to seal the deal.
Not messing around at all. They were focused, relentless, and they got the job done.
Here's Bitadze. Shoots over Leonard. Here's Leaf, and he uses the glass on the layup. There's 39 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Dragic the pass to Hill. Dragic against Holiday. Dragic kicks to Robinson. Offensive rebound. Here's Silva. shooting foul. As the whistle blows, he'll shoot two free throws.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good. That's also good, so he hits both free throws. And here's Holiday, who will bring it up for the Pacers. Passes it to Leaf, and it goes out of bounds. That one's off Holiday.
Careless turnover. You lose focus for even a moment in this league, that's the result.
Here's Nunn, guarded by Holiday. And they're going to move on to the conference semifinals. What a performance through the entire first round. Greg sweeping in four games.
And they really had a tremendous series. Watching how well these guys played as a unit has got to be scary for their round two matchup.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Jimmy, you have become a star in this league, big part of the team. Have those expectations put more pressure on you individually?
No pressure. I think I'm a do what I do each and every night. I'm not going to play well every night. So I just got to focus on me, this team. Can't worry about the outside of course.
A real leader, Jimmy. Thank you for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that about wraps it up for this broadcast of the NBA Eastern Conference Quarterfinals. For Steve Smith, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. So long.